I have a full-time job, 2 young kids, and 2 dogs. So, needless to say, publishing a new video once a week, even once every 2 weeks, is not easy. But after doing this for quite a while, I've streamlined this process and came up with a few tools that make this process faster and easier. Today, I want to talk about the tools I use, mostly on the software side, to help me plan, film, and publish videos. As soon as I come up with a video idea, I make a new note using Apple Notes on my phone. I've used a ton of different apps for this, but always find myself coming back to Notes. It's always with me, super easy to use, and syncs across all my Apple devices. And it has just enough formatting options to make everything nice and organized without being overwhelming. This allows me to get my ideas out of my head as quick as possible so I don't forget them. For my more complex videos, when I actually need to sit down and plan out the video, I've lately been using the Freeform app on my iPad. I don't use this for every video, but when I really need to plan and visualize my idea, Freeform is an amazing tool for this. The ability to write, draw, add pictures, links, and much more all in one place can really get the creative juices flowing. Next step is to script my video. For this, I use Apple Pages. Just like Notes, it's free, easy to use, and syncs across all my devices. So I can start on my Mac, where I can have Pages and Notes open side by side, and if I need to, finish it on my iPad. I find when I script my videos, the act of typing out what I'm going to say really gets me thinking about it, and whether I'm delivering the information in the best way possible. It also keeps me from rambling, which, let's face it, if I start rambling, you get bored, you click off the video, send the wrong signal to YouTube, who in turn shows my video to less people. So honestly, I can't say I'm doing this for my viewers, but really, I'm doing this for myself. Also, using Pages for this lets me open my script on my phone, which comes in handy a bit later in my process. Since most of my videos are tutorials, my next step is usually a screen recording of what I'm going to teach. I do this step before recording my A-roll, just in case I made any mistakes in my script. Any changes are still relatively easy to make at this stage. The software I use to record my screen is called CleanShot X. I prefer CleanShot X over QuickTime for a few reasons. It highlights mouse clicks and lets me customize how that looks. It logs keystrokes for on-screen shortcuts, and one of the main reasons I prefer CleanShot X is it allows me to record high-quality audio from my computer. When I record my tutorials, I also use an app called Keybell, and all that does is add a sound every time I press a key on my keyboard or click the mouse. Having these sounds in my screen recordings is super helpful, and I use the waveforms as markers to help me line up the screen recording with my A-roll. This actually saves a ton of time. After recording my screen and making any necessary changes to my script, my next step is recording A-roll. Since most of my videos are scripted, I do use a teleprompter. The one I use is the original podcaster from Parrot, and as far as saving time, this is by far one of the best investments I've ever made. Using a teleprompter cuts down on my filming and editing time exponentially. To go with this teleprompter, I use the free teleprompter app from Parrot. I just open up my script in Pages on my phone, copy the text, and paste it into the Parrot app. I can then adjust the appearance and the speed of my on-screen text to match the pacing I want for my video. This teleprompter also comes with a Bluetooth remote, so if I mess up, I can easily go back to my script without having to get out of my chair. When I film A-roll for my video, I like to record my audio and video separately. There's a couple of reasons for this. One is I like using my USB mic, and there's no easy way to connect it to my camera. And two, and this is actually the main reason I record my audio separately, is it gives me a separate audio file I can clean up before importing into Final Cut Pro. To record my audio, I just connect my mic to my laptop and use Audacity to record my audio. I was using GarageBand for a while, but I was always having issues with audio drift. I'm not going to go into the specifics in this video. All I'm going to tell you is if you want to sync your audio with video from a digital camera, do not use GarageBand. Logic is a good option for this if you don't mind paying, or if you want some free, it's hard to beat Audacity. Before importing my audio into Final Cut Pro, to clean it up, I ran it through Isotope RX Elements. I'm still using version 7, which you can't get anymore, but I'm pretty sure they're up to about version 10 by now. Whatever version you have, this is an amazing tool. RX Elements comes with a super useful repair assistant. It scans and analyzes your audio, detects any problems, and does an amazing job fixing them with just a few clicks. I know personally, I get quite a few clicks and pops in my audio, and RX Elements picks up and removes pretty much all of these in just a few seconds. If this tool is something you're interested in, but not sure about the price, I'd watch for it on BNH. They often have it on sale, and sometimes you can pick it up for as low as $10 to $15. With my audio cleaned up, I take my audio files, video files from my camera, and my screen recordings, and import them into Final Cut Pro. This is where I edit all my videos. Here, I can easily sync my external audio to my video files, sync up different camera angles if I use more than one camera, add titles and effects, and so much more. It's easy to use, and at least at the time of making this video, there's no subscription fee. Apple has been providing free updates for Final Cut Pro since it was first released way back in 2011. While on the topic of no subscription fees, to make my thumbnails for my videos, I use Pixelmator Pro. This has almost all the features that come with Photoshop without the monthly fee. Pay for it once, and it's yours to use as much as you need to. Pixelmator Pro also comes with a ton of useful templates for social media. You just select the template you want to use, swap out the elements, and you have a nice clickable thumbnail with proper resolution and aspect ratio ready to be uploaded. For uploading my videos to YouTube, I use Google Chrome. The sole reason I use Chrome for this is I can use the TubeBuddy extension. This extension started out as a simple tool to help you choose the best keywords for your title and description, and over time grew into so much more. I use TubeBuddy to help me come up with titles, A/B test my thumbnails, bulk edit video templates, just to name a few. I've been a TubeBuddy user almost from day one, and this is one service I actually don't mind paying a subscription fee for. The last tool I want to talk about today is Motion AI. I've only recently started using this, so I'm not quite comfortable recommending it yet, but so far it's been awesome. Motion AI is a calendar slash task management tool that uses artificial intelligence to plan your day. You just connect it to your calendar and add your tasks or projects. Motion then uses artificial intelligence to find optimal time for your projects without interfering with your calendar events. It's almost like having a personal assistant. Like I said earlier, I've only been using Motion for a few weeks, so once I get a little more familiar with it, if anyone here is interested, I can do a full video on it. Let me know down below. These are the tools I use to help me make my YouTube videos. The system is far from perfect, but it works for me, and it's always evolving, and I'm constantly on the lookout for tools to help me improve my process. If you have any suggestions, I'd love to hear about them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here in the next one.